श्रीकृष्णा 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 गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुसाक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः Mind and going beyond the mind is the topic. We function in this world through the mind, and the quality of the mind determines the quality of our functioning in this world. If the mind is disturbed, the functions cannot be perfect. If the mind is depressed, the function cannot be joyful. If the mind is confused, the functions cannot be decisive. Therefore, unless we take care of the mind while functioning in this world, we will be leading a life of self-destruction. Therefore, when we work in this world, interact in this world, exactly what is the process that is happening? In the morning class, we have seen that our life is guided and influenced by the likes and dislikes for which there is no reason, there is no logic. And therefore, our life is not logical at all. We may think, I am a person of reason, logic. Unless I am convinced, I am not doing. Now what is the conviction that you don't like something and you like something? No conviction. So that is one part of the mind we have to take care. And we take care of that by following a principle, what is called as duty-oriented lifestyle, karmanyeva adhikaraste ma phaleshu kadachit. Now the second thing is, when we are doing anything in our life, that time, what are the things that happen? So, the result of our actions is seen by us in three places. First, we may try to see the result of our actions in the world where we have been doing something. So, the field of action and the result of action is seen in the field. Now, to understand this abstract statement, let us take an example. And then what happens if we do this? It is something like, you know, when we are doing something in this world, like, you know, I give lectures. This is the only thing I do. Now, where is my attention? So, my attention in the first case could be to the world. I have been talking for so many years, people don't change, they are the same, disgusted, frustrated, all the time complaining, oof, I am fed up. So, I try to see the results of my action in the field where I am acting. And the result invariably is, your action in the world doesn't make any change. Because we are all the victims of the same situation. I am the victim of my mind. Similarly, you are the victim of your mind. So one victim is trying to improve the other victim. It is something like, you know, there are two cells in a jail. And in each cell, there is one prisoner, one criminal. And they can look at each other through the bars. That's all. Beyond that, they can't. So they start thinking, hey, let us help each other. How to get out of it? Now, both of them are inside. They can never be successful. Exactly the same way. When I try to talk to the world and try to give the best of the knowledge and expect that the world will change because of my talks, the guarantee is I will be frustrated in life. All the parents are frustrated because of this. They expect that the children should listen to them and they should live the life according to the decision of the parents. It cannot happen. Like, you know, I was in US, in California, and one Gujarati family, I went for lunch or something like that. And their son was a huge structure, 12:30 in the afternoon, sleeping in a bhujangasana. So his father told him, Swamiji, I have failed to wake him up to come for food. You try. So I said, hey, Mahatmaji, come for the food. Thank God he didn't push like that, you know. Bhujangasana can do anything. So I said, maybe he is not well. Oh, Swamiji is well. He keeps awake whole night, 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, we don't know what they do. All the time on the internet. And the room is closed. We don't know what is going on inside. And every day it is the same. So I thought, you know, my food he will spoil. So I said, hey, what is cooked? Immediately change the topic. You also take food. He said, no, Swamiji, you take. I said, all right, I'll take. And he was persistent, again started the same story. Swamiji, why he is like that? Back home, this is a standard phrase. Back home, when we were in Bombay, when my father used to come to my room, out of respect, I used to run and go to other room. Now, when my son comes to my room, out of fear, I go and run to other room. What is this life? I said, you have defined already. Your life is born to run. First because of father, now because of son. Run or run. No, my question is why this is happening? I said, this is happening because we were lucky to have good parents. Our parents were such that we were influenced by their presence. Our children are unfortunate. They have got such dumb parents that they don't get influenced or inspired by the parent. That is why it is happening. Therefore, when my actions, I see the result in the field, guarantee is I will be frustrated. This example I have given many places. One person asked me this youngster, a software engineer, Bangalore. He said, Swamiji, you have been talking so many years, I am listening to you. People don't change. Don't you feel bad about it? I said, have you changed? No, I am talking about the people. I said, no, I don't feel bad. On the contrary, I don't want them to change. Because if they will change, then where will I go? You know, a successful doctor need not be an efficient doctor. A successful doctor is the one who has the discrimination which patient should be maintained so that the money keeps on coming. And those doctors who cure the patient, they remain poor. I said the same principle we follow. We don't want people to grow wise. They should remain where they are, continue to be miserable. Then our market value is always maintained. Our shares don't fall. So, Where is our attention on the world? Net result, frustration. Now second place. When we are functioning in the world, our attention could be on I who is doing so many things. I have done this thing, I have done that thing, right from childhood, I had nothing, I worked hard, and there was one person, he is no more. The effect of this I, what I want to tell you, he was from Bihar, and when he was hardly maybe about 10-15 years of age, he ran away from home, went to some place, eastern part of India, and he was not even educated, maybe hardly 3rd or 4th standard, that's it, not educated. And then he joined some company and some role as a labor, you know. Hey, get a cup of tea.
Yes, sir.
Like that kind of. And slowly, slowly, he became so successful that he had his own industry, steel industry. And he represented Indian industrial delegation at the international level with his broken English. Very successful. The first time when I met him, he told me that. For about one and a half hour, he told me the whole detail. And I had no choice to run away. Right? Listen. Like you listen without any choice, I was also listening. So, after that, he took me to his house. And then the complaint started. Swamiji, I have got 2 sons. I don't know how to tell you, but both of them don't like me. They stay separately. Their wives don't come. Their children don't come to us. And my whole factory is only for them. Even in the factory when they come, they have got their separate offices, but they don't talk to me. What should I do? I say, you go and talk to them. After all, they are your children. No, but why they don't come and talk to me? I say, you ask them, they will be the right person. I told you this solution, you go and talk to me. No, no, I will not go and talk. This is all I have done. I thought again he is going to start the whole story. So what should I do? Then I told him, I said, you inquire why this is happening. Then I told him, as you told me about your past, so much detail, again and again and again and again, you must be doing the same thing to these children. Anything they go wrong, something happens, when I was small and we didn't have even shoes to put on, I worked so hard and you people are like that. This your I is so poisonous. And one gets disgusted of listening to that story of I. Now net result is, such a person is lonely in the crowd. He starts emitting all the negative vibes and nobody wants to be along with him. I have done this thing, I have done that thing. Now instead of having respect, love, understanding, an attitude of service, people have fear about such a person. And if anybody has fear about us, we are going the wrong way. See, friends, we are not the cobras or we are not the lions, human beings. Reverence is different, respect is different, and fear is different. Fear happens, Upanishad says, dvitiyatvai bhayam bhavati. Whenever there is no sense of oneness, there is a fear. See, friends, any organization where the, you know, this thing I was talking to one management forum, I told you probably, that the success of a top person in an organization is creating a feeling among the total staff that this institution belongs to them. not to me. Whatever may be the institution. If that happens, then only there is complete participation. There are two ways of doing the things. One way the things are done, no, I have to do this job, I am paid for this, therefore I am doing. In that participation, there is no heart. See, friends, on the contrary, if the top person is able to create such a way that everybody should feel that this is my place and I belong to this place, then only one is able to pour heart into every activity. And this can happen only when less of I, more of we. So when our activities are centered around I have done this, I have done that, such a person may be able to achieve success in the outer world, but inside such a person is lonely. He has nobody to be with. And although he may be in or among the people, yet he is lonely. Therefore, when we are functioning in this world, there is our attention, either in the world or on I. Both these things are working by the mind. We have to work on the mind. So as we have seen, working on the mind while functioning in the world. Now, how do we know that we are working on the mind with reference to I? This can come when we are generous enough to give due credit to those who have worked for. Then only this possible. Otherwise, I have done this thing, I have done that thing, I have done it, you do it. Some places, you know, I move around the world so many places. We come across this kind of situation. That, no, I was told I did it. You ask them, should we do this? Sir, you tell. People stop thinking. Because they have developed a character that here we are only to listen to the orders. You tell, we do. Because neither the responsibility is vested nor the freedom is given. And as a result, not only the work suffers, but individuals do not grow in their own life. Second thing, when we are able to take away attention from I, then we are able to bring out the best hidden talent in every person around us. If I is more important for me, then I don't care for others. I am concerned only about I, nothing else. See, friends, therefore, to work on this mind while functioning is to follow this principle. Give due credit to all those who are involved profusely. Then the third step. So first, attention is on the world where we are functioning. Second, attention is on I who is functioning. Both these are the wrong ways. Now the third way. Bhagavad Gita says, Yoginaha karma kurvanti sangam tyaktva atma shuddhaye. A yogi is the one who is doing karma, active in this world, ఆత్మశుద్ధయే ఫార్ ద ప్యూరిఫికేషన్ ఆఫ్ హిస్ మైండ్. ఇఫ్ యూ స్టడీ భగవద్గీత, ఎవ్రీవేర్ ద యోగా ఇస్ డిఫైన్డ్ ఇన్ ఎ టోటలీ డిఫరెంట్ పర్స్పెక్టివ్. ఫస్ట్ భగవాన్ సేస్ సిద్ధ సిద్ధ్యో సమో భూత్వా సమత్వం యోగ ఉచ్యతే. ఈక్వానిమిటీ ఆఫ్ మైండ్ ఈజ్ యోగ. యోగినః కర్మ కుర్వంతి సంగం త్యక్త్వా ఆత్మశుద్ధే. ప్యూరిఫికేషన్ ఆఫ్ ద మైండ్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వానిమిటీ. See, friends, so when we are functioning in this world, where is our attention? Are we doing something to improve the world, to change the world? Number one. Second, are we doing something to prove ourselves, I am better than you? Or whatever we are doing, is that action meant for purification of one's mind? If we are following the path of yoga, our mind must be pure. Now the purity of the mind again is defined in our Bhagavad Gita many ways. Right in the beginning, the teacher defines purity as equanimity. When we function in equanimity, then there is no sin created by us. Because what is sin? Sin is when any action leaves any impression on the mind, good or bad. That action which creates an impression on the mind, that action along with the impression is called as a sinful act. And such a person who is functioning and collecting impressions from the mind, and there are only two types of impressions, likes and dislikes, there is no third impression. And as a result, when we interact with the people, we develop these kinds of impressions on the mind. Somebody we like, somebody we don't like. And slowly, these impressions become so strong that our life is guided by these impressions. Therefore, the equanimity of the mind is the criteria of the purification of the mind. So, yoginaha karma kurvanti sangam tyaktva atma shuddhaye. The purification of mind is the purpose for whatever we are doing in this world. Now, the second thing, when we act in this world or do something, what are the reasons that can lead to the deposition of likes and dislikes in our mind? So here in Gita, Bhagavan gives this simple observation. When we do something, what are the possibilities that can happen? Number one, we will win or we are defeated. One person. When we win, we gain. When we are defeated, we lose. Third, when we gain, we are happy. When we are defeated, we are unhappy. So every action gives us three chances by which we can remain disturbed or by which we can maintain our equanimity. Three chances. And these three chances, if they are properly utilized, the net result is our mind will remain at peace. See? Therefore, same krutva tato yuddhaya yujyasva naivam papam avapsasi. So the yogis, the wise people, they are doing whatever they have to do in life in such a manner that the equanimity of the mind is not compromised. That is the most important. Now, as a result of this, what happens? When the equanimity of the mind is perfectly maintained, in that equanimous mind, there is no habitual reaction to the given situation. One stops reacting in the world. We normally react most of the time. And these reactions are only because we have trained ourselves like that. You must have seen, you know, this can be seen only in India, not anywhere else. Some dogs, when they see a car running, they start barking and, you know, attacking the car, and afterward the car goes, they feel they have done their duty. So one person asked me this question, Swamiji, why these dogs, you know, do like this thing? So I became angry. I said, what question you are asking? He said, Swamiji, you are angry? I said, no, you have insulted me. No, Swamiji, I never meant anything. I said, yes, why the dogs do like this? You ask me, am I a dog? Go and ask the dog, not me. No, Swamiji, I am not being seen. Please don't misunderstand me. And he started pleading. Then I told him, I said, look here, you can think about this very easy. See, out of the total number of pups that are born, all don't survive. Because these are small pups, they don't understand anything. They just go anywhere, here and there. And 2-3 out of 1 liter, suppose 5-6 of them, 2-3-4 just died, being crushed by the car or vehicle. And those who are alive, they see that. And if they happen to be grown up, then they feel, this is the fellow, you know, comes and kills. And therefore start barking. Oh, Swamiji, I see, yes, I can think what a dog can think. So that dog has developed that default setting. The moment the car comes, he starts barking. In the same manner, when we are functioning in this world, is our activity born out of wisdom, or our activity is just a default activity? Therefore, the next step is working on the mind means the most important thing. Whatever we are doing in this world, it is our need. The world does not need it. Make this point. You will never be miserable in life. Like, you know, we take care of the garden. And we go and prune it and clean it, remove the weeds and water it and take care of it. The garden doesn't want. If you don't give water to the plant won't complain. It will try to struggle, but it will die, never mind, ugly javanam. This is the problem. But we feel, I have done so much for the garden. Garden doesn't want us. We wanted something. Now apply this principle everywhere. Whatever we do in our life, that doing is our necessity. Now take your family example. A person gets married and thereafter 1 year, 2 years, 3 years gone. And then no baby, no child born. So they start getting frustrated and start doing all kinds of things. And finally a baby is born. Now from this example, who needs whom? The child needs the parents, or the parents needed the child? Think. If the parents needed the child, take care. You are not obliging by looking at your children. Take care of them. You have to take care. See, friends. But a parent develops this thing, I have done so much for my children. You have produced the problem, you solve it. See, friends. But the parents will never listen this and never understand this thing. Swamiji, you will not understand unless you become a father. And they have got only one AK-47, and that is the tears. And they start crying. Therefore, Whatever we do, it is our need. And when you do out of your need, you will be having humility. See, friends. And if we do something as if we are obliging the world, we will be having arrogance. So, when we serve out of humility, the mind is purified. And when we do something out of arrogance, the I becomes very strong. So how do we work on the mind? Working on the mind is this principle. That whatever we are doing in our life, nobody needs us. When we were not in this world, nothing was lacking. When we will leave this world, nothing will lack. The world will continue. See? We may call, oh, the great savior of the world. Rama came, went. What difference it made? Krishna came, he went. What difference it made? So many saints, the savior of the world. All the saviors have come, they were shaved and thrown. The world is the same. See, friends, there is nothing new that is ever happening in this world. Therefore, unless we become aware of this phenomena, then we are in this world for our spiritual evolution. That is the primary factor. And if this becomes the real purpose of our life, then our attention will neither be on the world nor on I, but our attention will be on the quality of the mind all the time. All the time means, before we take up any job, what is the quality of the mind? During the execution of the job, what is the quality of the mind? After the job is over, what is the quality of the mind? These days it doesn't happen. Earlier days used to happen. You know, the barbers used to go particularly in UP area, UP, Bihar, still, you know, backward area. So, there the barbers will be going from house to house. And they will be, you know, the landlords and all that, they will be arrogantly lying down. And the barber will come, and the landlord or whosoever may be, will be lying in the bed in the winter days, take out only his head, and the barber will start whitewashing. And then he will shave it. When that is being done, every cut he gives, after one cut, again he will start. Another cut, again starts. Every cut is followed by sharpening of the edge. So when I saw this thing somewhere in Lucknow, so afterwards I asked that barber, I said, hey, how many times you were doing like this thing? Why is it not sharp enough once you do and finish it off? So he looked at me. He said, you will not understand because you never shave. And then he told, very important thing. He said, the sharpness required for shaving and the sharpness required for cutting a tree has different quality. With that razor used for shaving, you can't cut the tree, and the axe with which you cut the tree, you can't shave. See how beautiful it is. Exactly the same way. If we really mean spiritual life, our sharpness, is it that of the cutting tree type of axe, or is it like that of the razor that is used for shaving. To be successful in the world, you require the sharpness of an axe. But to walk the spiritual path, you require the sharpness of a razor. Upanishad says, Kshurasya dhara nishita durityaya durgam padhastat kavayo vadanti. This path is like walking on the razor's edge. That sharpness. And that sharpness is, when we are functioning, our attention is neither on the success in the outer world, nor on the achievement or failure inside, but our attention is on what is the quality of the mind that is left when the job is over. That's all. I think you have to go and switch off on somewhere there. Try market. Otherwise, enjoy the garbi. Don't suffer. So, when we are thus focusing attention on the quality of the mind at three places, before the job being done, during the job, and after the job. Now, why bother about after the job? Because you have to use the same razor again on a second person. It is not use and throw. You can't throw your mind, you have to use the same mind again and again. See, friends. And this is what happens when we are angry with somebody. And with that mind, we leave that place, but we don't leave the anger there. We carry the anger with us. See? This example I had given. There was one man. He had a very bad argument and fight with his wife when he went for the office. So when you go to the office, you are an officer. You are not a husband. But he forgot to leave the husband at home. And he carried the husband with him in the office. And his subordinate, very good understanding between him and his secretary. So he wrote, secretary wrote, a casual, application. Sir, I'll like to take half day casual leave as I have to attend to my wife. She has to be taken to the doctor and I'll come by lunchtime. Normal thing. Immediately wrote. Nothing happens to the wife. No, not allowed. Are you a national husband, Rashtrapati or what? Nothing happens to the wife. Now why this happened? Because the husband in him was still alive. See, friends, because we have not learned this art. Keep things separated. Don't mix issues in life. This is how we have to work on the mind. See, like the doctors, they see a patient and after the patient is seen, treated, he goes away. The doctor has to drop the patient, the diagnosis, the medicine completely, make himself fresh. If he doesn't do that, then the second patient will come. And if the first patient was suffering from constipation and the patient has not left the mind of the doctor, the second patient comes suffering from dysentery, but he will treat him for constipation. The leftover effect of the earlier patient. He cannot be a successful doctor. They have to have the differential diagnosis. Should not mix up. Therefore, when we are functioning in this world, our attention should be on the quality of the mind all the time. Keep this example in front of your mind. Instead of keeping the Lord in front of your mind and worrying, but why is blue? Was he born because of the ischemia? What is the reason? Instead of that, keep the picture in your mind, a barber cleaning or sharpening his teeth. Keep this picture. Again and again. every moment. Take care of the mind, take care of the mind, take care of the mind. When you take care of the mind, then only the mind will listen to you. Otherwise, the mind won't listen. See, for example, I went to somebody's house and husband, wife and their only spoiled son. And that husband, wife told, see, Swamiji has come, do namaskar. No, I will not do that. See, now Swamiji has come here to do namaskar, please do it. No, I will not do that. And I was standing on the door. I told him, Maraya, do it, I am holding my feet in my hand, or let me get inside the house. Now that child, who is not disciplined, who doesn't listen to the parents, can you ask that child to do anything? Now why this happens? Because the only child is spoiled by the parents. No discipline, whatever the child wants, he gets it. He has never heard no in his life. See, friends, therefore, the same thing happens with the mind. And we suggest spoil the mind when we start leading our life. Our life is a mess. See? There are many people, they have got many good qualities, but they are unable to take care of their mind, therefore, they are extremely miserable inside. Outside they may show happy-go-lucky, happy all. But inside, because you know, when we come across many people, outside they show that everything is fine. One person once came to talk to me. Swamiji, I said, yes, Mr. Question, come. Swamiji, I know question. I just came to say hello to you. I said, okay. Sit down, say hello, 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 hello. Then he said, suppose, started an example, suppose somebody's wife beats him. What that husband should do? Then I said, he should put on bulletproof jacket. So that the beating remains on the jacket. And for that, ask that wife to provide money for the purchase of the jacket. Don't spend from your pocket. No, no, you are making a joke. I said, you know, look here. Theoretical questions are never answered. When you go to the doctor, do you ask a question like this? Suppose somebody is having dysentery, what he should do? Are you having? No. Why you worry about others? No, suppose. Then I ask him, instead of giving a theoretical example, why don't you tell straight away, this is your problem? And he says, Swamiji, yes. And then he told the whole story of his life. That, you know, she gets possessed by something and then she is out of her mind and what she does, she doesn't know. And she starts behaving so badly. Under this condition, what should I do? I said, this is the right question. See, friends. Therefore, how do we take care of our mind? This should be the approach of a spiritual seeker. Mind your mind, you are taken care of everything in your life. But this mind by which we come in contact with the world, we do not take care of that mind itself. Therefore, mind and beyond. Now the next step. There was one, I was standing in somebody's porch. House, very rich man, and he had a son, like a flag. Flag, you can see, little bit air, that kind of personality. He came on a big, you know, bullet motorcycle. Tang, 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 tang. when he was driving the motorcycle, like a flag, he was flying behind. Can you imagine that picture? He came and stopped and put the motorcycle and like this, you know, only bones. But he was thinking he is very strong. He went inside. And another car came immediately after 5 minutes. So this motorcycle was in the middle of the porch, so it has to be removed. So the servant was told, "Hey, Ramu, remove the motorcycle." Ramu is very strong and sturdy, but he doesn't know how to handle the motorcycle. Now when he was pushing it, he could not manage and the motorcycle fell on his feet, legs, and he was hurt. Now see, that Agarbatti flag brand fellow could ride on that motorcycle effectively. And this strong person, because he doesn't know how to handle the motorcycle, he suffered. Now apply the same principle. We may be extremely successful in the outer world by whatever means. You can cheat the world outside. In fact, we really cheat ourselves the most. We don't cheat the world. Because the world knows that this fellow is cheating. So he is not cheated, but he is in a need. He has to do that. But when we start cheating ourselves, where will you run away? And the cheating happens when we do not know how to take care of our mind. We do not know how to work on the mind. We do not know how to get the work done by a disciplined, obedient, capable, effective mind. You know, these days there is one technique. You must be seeing there are many highways, you have to pay the toll tax. You know why the toll tax is paid? This is called as BOT system. The road or the bridge is built by some private entrepreneur. He puts maybe few hundred thousand rupees or crores or like that, and a bridge is constructed. Now how to recover that money? Government won't give. So they have the contract. Build, operate. And when suppose they decide, on this road or bridge, there is this much of frequency of vehicles per day. And if they charge this much rupees per vehicle, at a time, per day they will be generating so much of revenue, and if this is allowed for n number of days, their total cost along with the interest will be recovered, and after that is done, whatever your profit or loss that is yours, and therefore after that is over, then the toll is suspended, no more toll is taken, then that road or that bridge is handed over to the government. This is the technique. So they call it build, operate and transfer, BOT. In the same manner, we work on the mind, build the mind, positive thinking, relax, cheerful, non-reactive, bathing in the light of wisdom. The peace of our mind is more important. The inspired mind is the cause of success. This is all bathing in the light of wisdom. And thus we build the mind. Then we operate through this mind in this world, and we will be collecting our toll in the form of cheer and joy. No frustration, no regrets, no arrogance, no guilt. And after this is done, then transfer the mind to the divine. Thereafter, a day comes in our life wherein, be attentive, we have attained fulfillment in life. See? And when fulfillment is attained in life, that experience is like if you take two pieces of iron rods, maybe 6 inches or 2 inches, and put them in two containers having iron nails and pull them out. One which is only an iron piece will go inside alone and come out alone. But if it is a piece of magnet, it will go alone, but when it comes out, it will come out with a lot of them. In the same manner, when the spiritual perfection is attained, and spiritual perfection is fulfillment in life. Fulfillment has got two qualities. Number one, there are no regrets and guilt about anything in life. And there is no arrogance about any success in life. Secrets. That is fulfillment in life. And if this fulfillment is achieved, then alone etat buddhva buddhivan chat kurta kurtascha bharata, then thereafter the small I disappears and the divine starts expressing through that. You know, this is something like this. One useless fellow, well built, good for nothing. Problem for everyone. And one day, somehow or the other, he gets a job of, let us take, a medical representative. Because they want this type of smart people. They may not have any other quality, smartness is enough. So they start moving with the bag in the hand, with samples. Earlier their language was different, now their language is different. Earlier the language is, I will do like this, what do you think? I will kill you. Gunda. After he joins a big company, thereafter the language changes. We produce, I has overnight become we. See, we produce this vaccine. By this vaccine, even a dead person becomes alive. This expansion from I to we. See, now he is no more a useless person of a village. Now he is representing the whole company. Now bring this to yourself. First of all, Narendra Modi, a tea vendor. Now representing the whole nation. He is the same physically, but he has expanded to such an extent that he now embraces everything, includes everything and excludes nothing. That is what is called as fulfillment in life. And a person who is fulfilled in life, he has no personal agenda. See, friends, if there is no fulfillment, there is a lot of personal agenda. And whenever there is personal agenda introduced in our activity, again, the mind will be polluted. Then those who are able to help me, they are good. Those who are not able to help me, eradicate me. And again, the samsara begins. See, friends, this is the most important aspect of keeping a constant, vigilant eye on the quality of the mind when we are interacting with the world. So before we begin anything, the quality of the mind must be inspiration. Most important. If we begin anything without inspiration, it becomes a burden. Okay, I have to go on. No. See, the inspiration, you can think in terms of an example. Like, you know, the athletes, they are standing at the start line and they are running with an inspired motivation. They are not doing, "Are baap re, itna dur daudna padega, try marte." No. They are going there of their own choice. Nobody has asked them, "Hey, run there for no reason." And we know all, it's not only one person, there are dozens of them, and all of them know there will be only one person. Yet they keep running. And everyone has only one principle, that they are inspired. And therefore, when they are inspired, be attentive. When they are inspired, they are ready. It is not like that, you know. No, I was inspired, but I was not ready, you know, to run. You are not inspired. So an inspired performance is a willful participation in life. Number one. Then, to keep this fulfillment in life all through is perseverance. There are three types of people. One type of people are those who imagine failure and they never start anything. Chodo yaar, what will you do? It's okay. They are laziest of all the lot. Second type of people are called as prarambhashur. Prarambhashur means they are inspired to begin, but then they stop. So, they begin something and leave it halfway. They never reach, they never complete. And the third type of people are those, more the difficulties come in their life, more inspired they become. Every difficulty as if brings out the best in them, because now their mind is functioning under a fulfilled condition. The joy of doing the things, not the joy after doing the things you get as a reward, no. Therefore, functioning in this world while we are working on the mind is this. Don't do anything in this life to get happiness from your actions. But let every action express happiness. Actions at the body level, actions at the speech, at the talk level is speech, and action at the thought level is at the level of the mind. Three things. So, when we do anything, it must express happiness. When you talk anytime, it must express joyful expression. And when we think, that thought must spring out of happiness. When we remain aware of this principle intensely, then alone we are working on the mind. And this becomes, after some time, a natural phenomena for us. Initially, we have to consciously put efforts. And when these conscious efforts are continued for a time, then like Patanjali said, prayatna shaithilyam. Thereafter, we start remaining effortlessly disturbance proof. Nothing disturbs us. Disturbances in the mind are thoughts. If there are no thoughts and we don't get disturbed, what is greatness about it? If there are thoughts and we don't get disturbed, then we are a genius. Therefore, Vedanta very clearly tells, don't be afraid of thoughts. See? But we constantly frustrate ourselves. and then sit down and bite the teeth and all kinds of, tortures of the body, the face, and I control the mind. You cannot. That is not the way. Therefore, Chitta Vritti Nirodha is not the ultimate. The ultimate is Tada Drashtuhu Swarupe Avasthanam. Chitta Vritti Nirodha is just a little bit step by step. That's it. Not the ultimate. Ultimate is Drashtuhu Swarupe Avasthanam, abiding in your essential divine nature. That is the ultimate. And when we thus start living, be attentive. As consciousness through the body, start living as consciousness through the mind. We start living as consciousness through the speech. Then, the limitations of the speech, the limitations of the mind, and the limitations of the body will not influence our performance in this world. This is the only way. No. Therefore, mind and going beyond the mind is the purpose of all spiritual practice. Rest tomorrow. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om. Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hari Om.